out of this and that. What a clever kitty cat.
Frankie needs help! That was most unkind of you, Figaro. Now I beg of you, save that little bird. Lend him a helping hand. Woof!
Oh. Hey! Gosh, steam's low.
It's the head wallet on the wall. Splash, splash, pow!
Well,
here's the home of Mr. G.G. Geek, daring adventurer, famous explorer, great athlete, pioneer woodsman, Indian fighter, trapper, and soldier of fortune. In the eyes of his son, that is.
Well, son, you're going to learn plenty about the great outdoors. I'm going to teach you how to make camping, how to build a fire, show you all about woodcraft.
Gee, swell, Dad.
And then I'm going to show you how to hunt.
Oh, boy, Pop. Maybe we'll get a lion, huh?
Well, we might get a rabbit.
Oh, boy.
I was driving a stagecoach between Tobar and Lompoc. $1 million in gold dust. Bandits lurking behind every rock. Gee-haw, mice. Get along.
Gee, Willikers.
Yep, there I stood. Engines coming from every which way. I'm knocking them off like flies.
God.
Followed his tracks into the densest jungle. Biggest tiger I ever shot. Charging straight for me. Hoofs a-pounding. Ground a-shaking. Cool and collected. What was that?
Sounded like a back tire, Daddy.
Oh, I thought it was a front. Well, here we are. Good a place as any. Let's hit the trail.
You got it, Pop.
Yep, drilled it right between the eyes. Toss it up again, son. Reminds me of the time in the Swiss Alps. I was guiding a party of four, scaling the Matterhorn. Well, this is a good spot. We'll pitch camp right here, son. You unpack the victuals and I'll hang up for meat, safe from the little forest creatures.
Hmm?
Any wild animals up here, Pop?
No, and if there was, I'd grab him by the tail, and I'd swing him around, and I'd twist his arm, and I'd jump on him, and then I'd give him the old heave-ho.
Come on, Pop. Let's skin that old lion.
Ah, come on, son. We gotta rustle up some grub. Now we rub two sticks together. This is the way the Indians did. Better put your sweater on. Not bad, huh? For not using any matches. Yep, son. Used to be known as Sourdough Joe. Best flapjacks in the Yukon. Mm-hmm. Really stick to your ribs.
What was that? A lion?
Nah, just forest noises.
Well, time to bed down. Good night, son.
Good night, Daddy.
Keep your powder dry.
Daddy. I want a drink of water.
Okay.
Daddy!
What?
We didn't say our prayers. And bless Mommy, and bless Daddy, and bless the lion. Amen. Daddy?
Yeah?
Do lions sleep in sleeping bags?
Oh, yeah, sure. Lions smile.
A lion?
Shoot him, Daddy! Hey, Pop, not this tree.
Never you mind. I'm checking this one first.
Mm.
gotcha. Stick him up. Ooh.
Him closer, Daddy.
Gotcha. Which way did he go? He's gone. Pull up stakes, son. We're breaking camp.
Oh, boy, Pop. You almost caught that old lion.
Yeah, I did. Well, it's lucky for him. Because I'd grab him by the tail, and I'd swing him around, and I'd twist his arm, and I'd jump on him, and then I'd give him the old heave-ho.
The lion! Ow!
Did I ever tell you about the time I was a race driver?
The cold, unrelenting law of nature has been and still is the survival of the fittest. Down through the ages, self-preservation was recognized as the first law of nature. Quiet! The headlong rush of time through several million years found civilization creeping in, and man's eyes were opened to the possibilities of the use of his hands in self-defense. Time sped on in his endless journey for a few more thousand years to the medieval period, when man made use of armor as a means of self-protection.
Okay, that's your cue, boys.
On a few more centuries. Then came the Romantic Age, when chivalry and fair play were introduced. Man has now become a gentleman. A couple of 100 years roll by, and we see man engaged in a crude form of fisticuffs. But due to the utter lack of science, these men could fight for only 75 or 80 rounds.
Oh, What's this?
Thank you.
That's what I told for you.